What's up, everyone? Welcome back to my channel. I know it's been a hot minute, but it is what it is. I'm not gonna sit here and explain. But yeah, life happens. I hope you all have been doing good. Life's been treating you good. I hope you all had a very Merry Christmas, and I hope you all have a Happy New Year. Today is New Year's Eve, and I'm gonna start this video off by saying Happy New Year. I wish you all the very best of 2023. I hope 2023 is the year for everybody, because I know it's gonna be the year for me. So anyways, it is 9:13 in the morning. You guys, last night I could not sleep for the life of me. Actually, I fell asleep, I want to say about 2:30, and then I woke up like around 4 something. I'm sorry, like at 3 something, and then 4 something, and then by the time I knew it, it was like 5 o'clock in the morning. I wasn't on my phone. I just kept waking up. I kept tossing and turning. I just couldn't go to sleep. I have really bad anxiety and depression, so it's very hard for me to sleep sometimes. I went to sleep like around 5, a little after 5, and it is 9:13 in the morning. So I'm running on 4 hours of sleep, if even that. I had to get up early because I have to come into the supply store. I know my eyes are very watery because I keep yawning. I'm so tired. But I had to come to the supply store because I have to make some t-shirts for tonight for an order that I received yesterday. I am going to go buy the t-shirts and the vinyl that I need. And make the shirts, because I told her that they would be ready by 11:30. They probably will be, because the shirts are very simple to make. This customer ordered a cup or a tumbler from me like a couple of days before Christmas. So one, I should have charged a rush fee, because you guys, I was literally busting my ass and making sure that I had everything done at least a day before Christmas. I want to say like this past Sunday, like a little after Christmas, this customer that I'm gonna get the shirts for messaged me, and she said, how much would you charge me for 6 shirts for New Year's Eve? I want them red, you know. And I gave her my prices. So then she said, when do I need to give you an answer? I said, I need an answer by Wednesday. I said, because it'll give me enough time to be able to take my time to do it, you know, the right way. She said, okay. Wednesday came around. I messaged her like around 2 o'clock, and I asked her, I said, hey, this is Floor. You know, I'm just catching up with you and seeing if you want the shirts done. No answer. No answer until yesterday, which was Friday. And she was telling me that how she lost her phone, and you know, she still wants me to make the shirts, but she only wanted, you know, so many shirts. And I said, okay. So, you know, I could have told her something, because, you know, we both have iPhones, and it said that she read the message on Wednesday, but she never responded back. So she said she lost her phone and had to get herself a new one. You know, she was like, can you have them done early in the morning? And I said, excuse me, you just messaging me at 7 o'clock at night asking me about these shirts. And I told her, I said, the next time I'm gonna have to charge you a rushing fee. I said, because I have to go out of my way, because I told you to tell me at a certain date, you know, if you want this stuff done, you didn't do it. So she's like, I understand, you know, blah 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 blah. So here I am, coming to the store at 9 o'clock in the morning. They opened at 9. I was trying to get here, but right before they opened, or like right at then when they opened, but with me going to sleep, at the time that I did, it was impossible. I'm even surprised that I'm even up now. Because, guys, I'm so tired. I'm going to make her these shirts. And then I'm also going to buy some extra vinyl because I am getting ready to go to participate in a vendor event, which means I have to have all my stuff that I'm going to sell. I have to have it ready. The good thing is that it's until February. So it gives me all this time to be able to make as much stuff as I can. Yesterday, I was going to work on a lot of t-shirts, but the main colors that I use for vinyl is white and black, and I didn't have any white or any black. I had every other color except for white and black. So I'm going to buy me some extra white and black vinyl and some other colors just to have. And then I have to go to work today, so I'll probably do the shirts and stuff when I get home. And then, you know, be with the family for New Year's Eve. And then do what I gotta do tomorrow. And then the kids go back to school. You guys, the kids were off for 2.5 weeks. And it doesn't even feel like they were off for 2.5 weeks. I love having my kids home with me. My kids are, you know, I'm not gonna say they're angels. But my kids are very good kids. And they're very chill kids. I hardly ever hear them fighting and arguing with each other. You know, they just like to mind their business. They, you know, play their video games. They go outside. They, you know, they come to my room and chill with me sometimes. But yeah, for the best part, my kids are some damn good kids because they're very respectful. They, you know, they don't disrespect anybody. I cannot stop yawning. Another thing that I wanted to talk to you guys about is, you know, someone who deals with anxiety and depression and, you know, just has mental health issues, they go through a lot. I am one of them people that goes through a lot, that I, you know, I don't ever, like, I'm never consistent with anything because I never know how I'm gonna feel in an hour, in 2 hours, you know. But I think the Starbucks is right there. But this coming year, I'm not gonna make any promises, but this coming year, I do wanna be a little more consistent in making videos. One thing that I am going to say is, I'm going to say this because I've seen a lot of, my throat is completely dry. I've seen a lot of people on YouTube talk about it, and I can never understand the reason why people do this, but this is one thing that I am going to say. For all the people that come on the videos and like to talk mess, like to judge people, like to criticize people in the worst way possible, people that like to judge other people's relationships, you guys, one thing that I'm going to say about all of that is, you little internet thugs can talk whatever you want behind the screen. Y'all can say what you want about me, about my family. Y'all can say anything. You can say whatever you want. It's not gonna bother me. You guys, I completely forgot to take you guys inside the store with me, but I already got the bag with the shirts and the vinyl. But anyways, like I was saying before I went in the store, there are some of you people there. I'm not gonna say some of you people, but there are people out there that are judging everybody by their 15-minute video. You guys, it's only a 15-minute video. Yes, they might post every single day. Yes, they might post every now and then, but they're only gonna post what they want you to see, or we're only gonna post what we want you to see. For all those ones that like to judge, criticize, just talk shit about everybody and what they see in the video. One thing that I am gonna say, when I start reading comments to the videos that I post, I'm not gonna show any attention to the bad or negative comments. I'm just not gonna give it any time or day, because once you start talking about because once you start giving attention to the bad or negative comments, you're gonna start getting more and more and more. One thing about me is that I stopped giving up a long time ago. I used to care about what people would say, how people would feel. Now I just don't care. Why? Because one, you're not paying my bills. Two, you're not sleeping with me. Three, I sleep a lot better with me knowing that I have nothing to worry about. You know, for all the haters that are hating on me for whatever reason, family or friends or just whoever is judging me or hating on me, they're my biggest fans. So I'm not gonna put, or I'm not gonna give it any attention whatsoever. So from here on out, I don't care what you guys read in the comments and, you know, assumptions or accusations. I'm not going to, if the accusations are not true, I'm not going to give it any attention. I'm not going to give it any time or day. You want to talk crap, you can talk crap all you want. Anybody can talk shit. But I can guarantee you that if you see me in person, you ain't going to say anything. So, one, if you ain't perfect, I go by this little slogan or saying or whatever you want to call it. Judge me when you're perfect, because I can guarantee you there ain't nobody in this world besides the man upstairs that is perfect. So once you're perfect, then you can go ahead and judge anybody and everybody that you want. You can talk shit about my marriage and my relationship that I have with my husband. I can give two flying fucks, because who are you to judge? Your life is just miserable that you have to go on YouTube and watch everybody's video and just go in the comment section and just talk all your shit. That's just plain and simple. You're living a miserable ass life and you have nothing else better to do but try to ruin other people's relationships, other people's families, you know. And I know this for a fact because I've seen a lot of videos recently on YouTube talking about this, why their relationship ended, because people were talking down on their relationship. People were just completely trashing their relationship, and they ended the relationship because of that. You guys, that ain't gonna faze me any at all. I can give, I don't care. You know, you can talk whatever mess you want. I don't care. If it ain't true, I don't care. If you don't have the facts, I don't care. If you don't have proof, if you don't have facts, if you don't have anything to fucking show with receipts, I don't care. I don't care, you know. And everybody has a past. Everybody has a story. Yes, I know. I'm not saying that I'm perfect. I'm just saying I don't care what you guys have to say about me or my family. Or when it comes to that part when I start getting a lot of comments. When I get a lot of comments about whatever, any negative or bad comments, I'm not going to give it any attention, because like I said before, I deal with anxiety and depression, and I'm not gonna let that bring me down. It's not gonna happen. So I'm gonna try my hardest to post on YouTube a lot more. But I'm going to try my hardest. I'm not making any promises. I'm going to try my hardest to make more videos on YouTube and interact with you guys. Right now, I'm on my way home. But first, I'm going to stop by Dunkin' to get me a coffee, because your girl needs a coffee. the plans that we have for tonight, I don't know. I'm very clueless because me and my husband have been talking about this since Christmas, and we don't know. Only because we spent a lot of money on Christmas, you know, for gifts for the kids and stuff. So we don't know what we're gonna do. I know we're gonna buy them a little bit of fireworks, and over here where we live, it's legal to pop fireworks. People go to like shopping centers and the parking lots, and it's, I'm talking about, there's a crowd in every parking lot just popping fireworks. And yes, they pick up their mask because I drive by the next day and it's clean. So that's a good thing. So I don't know what we're gonna do tonight. I'm just going with the flow. I'm gonna make the shirts, and then I'm going to go to work for a little bit. Maybe till like 3 or 4, I don't know. And then come home and work on some more stuff for this vendor event. I'll show you guys a few things that I've made already. That I'm gonna, you know, I need a little bit of touch up on some things, but other than that, I have some stuff ready. I just have to make, I just want to make sure that everything is I just want to make sure that everything is in perfect condition or to my liking or whatever, and then pack it up in the box so that way I can have it ready to go. And I will also make a video on how I started my business, or how my little business came about, because I never thought in a million years that I would, you know, have a small business. But that's gonna be for a little story time or another video. There is a story time that I do want to make, and it's about me opening up about my last relationship and what it's put me through, because I talk to a lot of people, you know, and I let them know about everything that I've gone through, what I've been going through, you know, and they tell me that I should, you know, talk about it publicly, because there's so many people out in this world that are going through the same exact thing that I went through, that I'm going through. I know for one that video is going to be everywhere because, you know, I was in that relationship for 13 years. I've been out of that relationship for 6 years. So, you guys, so it's going to be, I have to take time to like jot down from how it all started to how it all ended, and, you know, what I'm going through now. So it's going to be a video to come. And it's just one that I'm not, that I don't want to put out there, but, you know, it's not for any, just for any bad reason. It's just because, I mean, it's been, you know, it's a 13-year relationship, and I've been out of it for 6 years. You know, it's just the past tense, you know, it's just something I don't know if it's because I'm just not ready to open up and to let everybody know, but it's just because it's gonna be a long ass video. And if it is a long ass video, it's probably gonna be done in like two or three parts. So who knows? We'll see when the time comes. I mean, the family that I'm close to should know everything. Well, they don't know everything, but I will make the video. It's like I said, it's just gonna take me some time, and I'm gonna have to write down like notes, like, you know, from how it all started to then to now. So like I said, right now I'm on my way to Dunkin' Donuts. Y'all, I've been seeing Dutch Bros going crazy, like all over TikTok and stuff. But I went once, And I forgot what I got. It was something campfire or something. And the coffee was nothing, tasted more like milk than it did anything. I went back again and then I got something different. Maybe I thought maybe it was just the coffee that I got, or the I should say milk that I got. And it was just, I don't know, I didn't really like it because I feel like it was more milky than it was caffeine, you know. And it was a lot more like it was a lot of whipped cream, it was a lot of caramel, there was a lot of whole bunch of shebang in there except for the coffee. I'm like, where's the coffee? You know, the color of the milk is brown because of all the syrups y'all are putting in here, but where's the fucking coffee? Like, so I stopped going. I only went twice and I stopped going because I was like, this ain't my cup of tea, because your girl gotta have some, has to taste some kind of coffee in her coffee. And when I go over here to Dunkin', I always get the iced white chocolate latte. Or if I don't have the white chocolate, the toasted white chocolate, I get the caramel. And then with extra pump of caramel syrup with the foam, with the cold foam, and less ice. Because you have less ice, you get more drink. You get a lot of ice, you get less drink. And then that's what I get. That's my coffee, what I get. And then if I do get something, it's always a sourdough breakfast, something with something, sourdough something. So that's what I'm about to order. Hopefully they have the toasted white chocolate mocha, whatever it's called, because your girl needs it. So there's the there's the Dunkin' right there. They don't have the toasted white chocolate.
Welcome to Dunkin', how can I help you?
Yes, can I get a medium iced caramel latte with an extra pump of caramel?
Medium iced latte with extra pump of caramel?
Yes, light ice and the sweet cold foam.
You said what's sweet cold foam?
Yes, and light ice, please.
Alright, well.
And that's it. Thank you. They don't have the toasted white chocolate. I got my coffee. Oh my god, you guys, it is so good. I've been going to Dunkin' Donuts. And for I don't know how long, I quit going to Starbucks, you guys, because this drink right here that I get, to me, it tastes like the white chocolate drink that they have over here at Starbucks. If you have to add an extra pump of caramel for it to taste like that. And it tastes just like a Starbucks coffee, just cheaper. I'm not gonna pay no $8-$9 for a coffee when I can pay half the price over here. And plus Starbucks would always get my order wrong. But you guys, I am back home. I would record me making the shirts and stuff, but my husband is in the room sleeping because he got home like around 5 o'clock in the morning from work. So I don't want to make so much. I already know I'm going to wake him up because of the heat in the room, because I'm gonna have to turn my heat press on. But I don't want to make them up, so I will show you the end result, and I will show you a couple of things that I've done already. So I'll see you in real life about 30 minutes, but on here in about a second.